Okay, I got an AC down. Points look a little worn on the contactor. Capacitor looks a little tired. But nothing's running here. Here, I'm gonna go ahead and pull my disconnect here. And then come over here and we'll discharge the capacitor. There we go. Let's see. Compressor's pretty hot. I'm thinking maybe the condenser fan motor stopped running. Don't see any burned wires. Everything looks okay in there. On the, this one here. Open that up. Alright. Woo! Got 116 today. The roof here. Kind of humid. It's usually not so humid. Uh oh. It's going to be a stubborn one too. This should be secured a little bit better, so I'm going to show you how to do that. There's a couple different ways, but I'll show you one method here. I'm going to go ahead and pull my disconnect here, and then come over here and we'll discharge the capacitor. There we go. And then we'll discharge this little capacitor. So I just got my screwdriver in there to bridge the leads. Finish. This off here. Okay, and then we're gonna slip our leads off the old capacitor here. There we go. And now what we're gonna do is we're gonna make a place to mount our new capacitor. We got my new capacitor here. We're gonna hook this up. But we really don't want this just hanging there free. I mean, sometimes you do. You gotta do it, but it's a little bit better if we can mount this. And what I have is some plumber strap and then some self-tapping screws. So we can just hook this up a little bit better, make this a little bit safer and easier for somebody in the future. Just the main thing is we want to make sure that there's nothing behind here that this is poking into. I've worked on these units a lot. In this particular model, there's nothing behind here, so. But on other models, you're going to have to check and verify that there's nothing back there so that you don't wind up poking into some refrigerant tubing or anything like that. Okay. Excellent. Looks like that's going to be a little too tight on that hole, so I'm going to go with this hole here. Probably better to go with a little bit stronger drill than that, but that'll work. So now if we ever have to replace it again, we can just slip it out, slip in the new one. We're good to go here. Now I'm gonna go ahead and plug my disconnect back in and make sure everything starts up okay. Oh yeah, our fan motor blades kicked on right away. So that's with the start capacitor. Obviously if the motor didn't start, then the motor would be bad. the line is nice and cold. So anyway, that's how to make the unit a little bit safer.